All right, so we've been manipulating lots and lots of vector shapes in Photopea. We're just going to hold on a little bit longer and finish it up and then upload it. And then I'll show you how we can do some custom shapes or customizations to these shapes using layer styles. First of all, I'm just going to duplicate, multiply this hair a little bit. Control T, because I'm in Photopea. And flip horizontal, move it over. And I don't want it to look too orderly. So I'm just gonna kind of move it like this and down. Then I'm gonna duplicate it again, Command J. Oops. And then maybe, let's see, Control T. Flip horizontally, rotate it, maybe shrink it a little bit using scale. Hold down shift to distort it a little bit. I think that works. Maybe push this one up just a little bit. Okay, so I've got kind of flat shapes. If I decide it looks like Bucky, but I don't like how there's no kind of white around the muzzle, then I can simply do this and still keep it as flat shapes. I can use my ellipse tool and make one big ellipse that I put around the muzzle. Control T, kind of shape it so it fits around it, like so. Sink that back behind those muzzle shapes, like that, and then fill it with a much lighter gray. Sink it back a little bit further behind the eyes, and then I can Control T and warp it and tuck in the edges here. So it's a way of kind of giving a shape around the shape. This is what's called offsetting, to help it show up on different backgrounds. But I'll show you that more with some of the options we have. So right now, this is my design. I've turned off my two raster layers, which I brought in from Emoji Maker, so that the background's just empty checkerboard. It can be helpful to make a new layer that sits right at the bottom of all your shape layers that you just say Edit Fill, and you fill it with middle gray at 100%. And that will just show you if you have any kind of shapes that are hidden anywhere. It's a good thing to do for a kind of t-shirt design as well. And then I'm going to turn that background layer off. Again, turn off all raster layers. And then I'm going to say File, Save. That will update my PSD, which is going to my folder. No, it's not. It's going to the desktop. Should be going to the desktop, right there. And if I'm at all unsure at this point, I can say File, Save More, Save PSD / PSB. And then when I click Save there, it's going to download and save it to my Downloads folder, which I can just then move to my desktop and replace any old one. So I think it was saving, it just wasn't keeping up with it. So there's ways to be safe before you leave Photopea. You can also sign in for an account for Photopea and get like half a gig of cloud storage free, but cloud storage has its own problems. Okay, so now I'm going to say File, Export as a PNG, and a PNG will support transparency. save at 100% quality. This will go to your downloads folder. You can move that onto your desktop as well. And when you click on it to open, it will show on a gray background because that's how Preview defaults it. Okay, next, we got to put it up into the assignment. So I've posted my emoji maker. Now it's time to show how much that changed. So this is flat vector layers or vector shape layers in Photopea. You don't need to label it just as long as your name is there. You're not required to put your flat emoji maker one in unless you think it's interesting. But you are required to put something in before midnight tonight to show me your process. In our presentation critique, you're going to say, what did you find most helpful? What tool was most helpful? Right? But I'm going to make some space. So with layer style effects, because just like I have in the directions here, once you're done with your flats, then you have the option of using layer styles. You see all these effects here? We can build shadows, textures, gradients, and I'm going to show you that. So, first, the big difference with the illustrations of Bucky is that his head has kind of this ombre effect from like lighter gray to black. So to fill it with a gradient, I'm going to select this and then double click on that layer to open what are called layer styles. And I'm going to use the gradient overlay. And I get to decide what that gradient is. And I want it to go black to white. But I also get to decide the angle of it. And I want it at negative 90 degrees. Or I could always just hit reverse from 90 degrees. So these are called layer styles. And you get to them by double clicking on the layer, not on the name. But to the right of the name in that empty space. Okay, so that ombre effect works pretty well, but I could also give it some texture if I wanted to make it kind of dappled and not so flat. And I can use different patterns for this. I tend to like this sand diffused pattern, and I can play with different scales at different depths. And this can be pretty subtle, but this is to make it kind of a really fancy emoji. So I'll zoom in and show it to you. Now, what's great about these light layer styles is there's a little effect icon, and then you can drop it down, and you can zoom in, and you can see what it's doing. So if I turn it off, you'll see that it won't give me that bevel that came with the texture. And if I turn off the gradient, it will just give me the flat color again. So that texturing gave me a little highlight on one side and a bevel on and a dark shadow on the other. Just little things. Now, what about these eyes to make them kind of the soft-edged glow? This is one of my favorite things. I double click, I go to layer styles, and I'm going to go to what's called an inner glow. I'm going to make that inner glow white. I'm going to make it noisy and opaque, and I'm going to spread it. Quite a bit. You can see it previewing. You can jitter it, so it's not so. Jitter means it will vary from edge to edge a little bit. And now this is a nice trick. I know I want that same effect on the other blue eye, which is above it. So instead of having to redo that, I just right-click on the effects. See if it will let me do this. I go to where it says layer style and I say copy, and then I click on the other one I right click. I don't right click, rather I right click and go to layer style and paste. And it will put that same effect on both sides. So that's helpful. What else? Let's see. I can give a stroke so that there's a dark edge on the bottom of the ears, right? So again, double click on the layer, and this time I'm going to use stroke. Click on it, go on the outside, choose a color, make it a dark gray, maybe steal it directly from my image, say okay. You'll get used to these, and these are extras because there's a lot you can do with them. And then instead of growing it on the outside, I'm going to grow it on the inside of that ear. And then maybe take the opacity down a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to copy that, right click, layer style, copy, and then paste that onto the other ear. Right click, layer style, paste. Maybe I want a similar thing on the eyes, like around the eyes. So I can just go to right click, layer style, paste. But on this one, let me alter it. I want the stroke to be on the outside. And I want it to be a little less opaque, kind of a dark shadow. Okay, then I copy that, layer style, copy, and I put it onto the other eye. So you're seeing the pattern. I can do that with the nose. It's kind of giving everything a slight shadow around it. And then if you want to edit it, you just open up the effect. Effects can also be turned off for any of these layers, so you can get back to your flat color as well. Let's take the size down around the nose. Maybe make it on the center. Now center will split the difference between the inside and the outside. It will grow equally from both. Okay, what about these muzzles? They're so dark. It'd be nice to have kind of a white glow around them, kind of like the eyes. So let's do that. Let's do an inner glow. It will remember my last settings, but I can take the noise down a little. Well, no, maybe up the noise and take the size down. And then maybe take its opacity down a little bit. And then I'm going to add that effect by pasting it, copying it, and pasting it onto the other. Where is that other one? There it is. And to the bottom jaw as well. So it is a lot of fun to be able to copy and paste layer styles. And it's very helpful. It gets a lot done. All right, I'm going to show you beyond gradients and bevel and embossing and textures. You can add as many of these things as you want. These different effects. And you can add them at different opacities and at different blending modes. So if I do kind of an inner glow on this, I can make it larger. That will give me some of the texture in the head. This is taking quite a bit of processing for Photopea, so you always want to save it first. And you have to be patient. See, I think I want to lessen its spread and increase its size so it doesn't look so defined. There we go. And take its opacity down a little bit. You can also